Good morning, students. I hope you all are well. Today we are going to start our first computer class with chapter 1. I hope you all bought the books. If you have book, open your book. Page number 7. First chapter is about networking concepts. Okay, now I will explain you with this video presentation. This presentation is same as your book. You can open your book or you can watch it. Presentation. Okay, let's start. In our daily life, we can across different types of network. Let us understand this concept by some examples. Network of roads, railway lines, canals, etc. all are different types of networks. Communication network of telephone system, which enable us to talk to anyone, anywhere, anytime. Okay, network of banks, automated teller machine, ATMs also examples of different types of network. Radio, television network, broadcast programs, live across the globe. Video conferencing allow discussion between people at distant, far off places. Network of malls, schools, hospital, etc. all over the country. Imagine life without networking. No phone, no television and no internet. We can't live without internet. Nowadays internet is very essential for us. Computer network have extended the power of a computer beyond the expanse of a room. It lets know more when two users have simultaneous conversation via internet. It is called conference. And when this process is supplemented by live video called video conferencing. When we talk to someone live, face to face we are doing chatting. This is called video conferencing. Next topic is introduction to network. Now we are discussing about computer network. Can be defined as a group of computers and other peripheral devices that are linked together for the purpose of sharing data and hardware resources. For example, you can see in this diagram, one of the computer in a network has a printer attached to it, then all the computers in the network can access the printer and use it. You can see in this diagram there is a three computer, computer A, B and C, and the all are connected with this hub, and printer is attached with computer B. It means all the devices are connected with each other. Okay, when we give command in computer A for printing something, so it means it can print from B and C computer also. Consider figure a computer A and B in a network can give the print command to the printer attached with computer C. Okay, the computer in a network can communicate with each other as well as work independently. Each computer in the network is called a node. You can see all the computers, every computer is called a node. Computers in a network can be linked through cables, telephone lines, radio waves, infrared light beams. Next topic is advantages of network. Okay, understand what is computer networking? It is the interconnection of various computers for the purpose of communication. Communication includes exchange of data, file transfer with the help of computer system, software application and users. Computer networking can exist between two computers and continue to happen between hundreds and thousands of computers. Okay, two devices are said to be networked with the process in one device is able to exchange information with the process in another device. Okay, understood? Now the computer that are involved in the network that originate, route and terminate the data are called nodes. Interconnection of computer is accomplished with a combination of cables or wires, media networking hardware. Okay, now next topic is advantages of networking. What are the advantages of networking? Why we are using networking in every field? Networking computer bring efficiency, economy and effectiveness in an organization. It makes our organization effective and efficient. It is next efficient use to storage media also. It is better to store a shareable application data on a network drive than to store a copy of the application on each user's storage device. Next is preserving information. We can save our information very safely. It is difficult to maintain regular backups on a number of standalone computers. That's why when you keep backups on a central location, you have one place to look for the lost information. Okay, we can retrieve our information from the main server. Next, reduction in hardware cost. Okay, in a network, the hardware devices that are not used very often like modem, printers, scanners, CD writers, etc. So can be shared. Okay, we don't need to use so many printers and so many modems for every computer. This reduces the cost of hardware. In a network, next is efficiency. Network, the deletion, modification, and upgradation of the software data is to be done at a single point only. This brings more efficiency and effectiveness into a working system. Next is redundancy. Network reduces the need for hardware copies of all the documents. By sharing the soft copy of a file over the network, the need to share paper copies of reports or any other information. It means paperwork can be eliminated or greatly reduced. We need not so much hard copies of all the documents. Networking next is quickest document delivery. Networking provides the facility to instantly deliver soft copies from one computer to other computers. Computers throughout the world also. Next, know the factors. Bluetooth. About Bluetooth. You can see this is the sign of the Bluetooth. What is Bluetooth? It's a wireless technology used to interconnect mobile, phone, computers, printer using short range of wireless connection. Okay, this is used for wireless connection. We can share our information via mobile, through computers, printer. We can exchange the information with Bluetooth. It's a wireless connection. Next, networking components. Which components are used for networking? To establish wired networking in a group of computers, you require some additional components that are as follows. Okay, for setting a network, we need some devices. Network card, first is network card. You can see the picture, what is network card? Network card is used to physically attach a computer to a network so that it can participate in network communication. Ethernet network card is the most commonly used network card. You can see the picture. What is Ethernet card? Nowadays, most computers, motherboards come with an inbuilt network cards. Okay, we need not external network card. They are coming with internal network card. It provides the in physical connection between the network and the computer workstation. You can see this light is blinking. This is network card. Most NIC, we can call it NIC, are internal and they are included in the purchase of most of computers. This card is major factor in determining the speed and performance of a network. It's a good idea to use fastest network card available for the type of workstation you are using. Okay, now next, networking cable. You can see this cable. Modern Ethernet network use twisted pair cable containing wires. Okay, these wires are arranged in a spatial order and RJ45 connector. Okay, this is the name of connector, RJ45. Similar in design but bigger than the connector used with the telephone wires, crimped at both the end of the cable. You can see. Okay,